considered to be of a very high level because it deals with a lot of thinking and meditation regarding your one wisdom mind. Dzogchen itself, literally translated, means, Dzogpa Chenpo means the great perfection or the great completion. It is a stage where you complete. A term exclusively to the Nyingmapa teachings of Tibetan Buddhism, referring to the highest category of the tantric practices. In this completion stage, the practice of Anuttara Yoga Tantra, after accomplishing the generation stage practice known as in Tibetan the Kirim, in which a practitioner concentrates on the vital points of his bodies, especially the mind, and engages in practices such as the merging, the abidance, and the dissolution of the energy winds into the central channel. Today, being very brief on the Dzogchen teachings, we will stress mostly on generating the wisdom mind and in trying to obtain enlightenment or realizing the wisdom mind through meditation. This meditation will be dealt with mainly one of the most important Dzogchen practices of the coming, staying, and the going of your mind.
You will be required to put full concentration into your thoughts and minds. So relaxing, please listen to the discourse as well as together continue the meditation. When we do the meditation of coming, staying, and going of the mind, we have to have an eye which watches the mind. When that eye watches the mind, it means it watches the thoughts that were there before, the thoughts that are there now, and the thoughts where they will disappear. So this stage is known as knowing the coming, staying, and going of your mind. When we begin this practice, you will have a lot of many different kinds of thoughts, and you will feel that you cannot follow them all, which is in a way very good, because then you are observing your thoughts. coming from the mind. Now at times when there are so many thoughts, try to follow one. Where was that thought a little moment ago? Where is it now? And after some time, where does that thought vanish?
法王說當他為我們開示關於大圓滿心法的時候，他希望我們大家能夠專一去聽，即是要專心聽，同時要不要緊張，放鬆的心，然後專心去聽。這樣他教你要怎樣去做的時候，你收的時候，你就跟著他的說話去做就可以了。他說當我們收這個 观察我们心的三种性的时候，就是心的生起的地方在哪里，心的住处在哪里，和心的去的地方在哪里。当我们这样观察的时候，我们就要有一个眼，这个眼就是说能够观这些一切的这个心的眼。 我们要观我们这个心过去的心、现在的心和将要灭去的心，或者是我们要观过去的念头、现在的念头，或者是将会灭去的念头。这个就是称为心的生处、心的住处、心的去处三点。当我们跟着去观察的时候，可能那时会生起很多妄念的我们的心。 我使我哋唔能够集中，但系唔紧要，冇灰心，因为呢个系一个好嘅现象。因为如果你能够发觉到你咁多念头生起咧，表示你已经有一种觉察嘅能力，唔系话懵懵嘅。咁样嗰阵时咧，我哋就要注意我哋呢个心念从何而来，从何住住，而从何而消失咧？
Give you 2 minutes to think about what we talked about before. Just try to observe where your thoughts were, is now, and going.
俾你哋2分鐘嘅時間去思維，思維一下我哋嘅念頭喺邊度嚟，嚟咗又住喺邊度，然後又喺邊度消失咗去咧？2分鐘時間去思維。
You feel certain when you meditate in this way, you cannot find anything, right? Okay. Or even if you do find an answer, the answer will probably be emptiness. It comes from nowhere, it is nowhere and going nowhere. But that is not the answer. Keep trying in this way because the essence, the nature of mind is absolutely not emptiness. There is something.
当你依咁嘅方法去观嗰阵时咧，咁可能你乜嘢都揾唔到嘅，咁可能你会答话系空噶啦，我嘅念心念系冇从边度嚟，又冇住喺边度，又冇去边度啊，咁林伯姐话咧系讲依个答案唔满意，佢对依个答案系话你再继续去观，因为 我哋呢個心嘅心性咧，唔係只係空性。
Looking down from here, you all look very good in your good meditative posture, and so His Holiness acknowledges your keenness and the very nice meditative posture that you are able to make. So He is clapping His hands, but don't let this increase your ego.
话咧，佢喺佢个座上咧睇落嚟，佢睇见各位咁提起精神，然后个个坐到好正，响坐到好直，佢觉得好高兴。佢即系表，即系表示你哋个个咧都有心爱学，有兴趣爱听嘅。咁佢就所以去拍掌，呢种鼓励我哋大家。但系任伯姐话咧，但系你哋唔好太过高兴，唔好令呢个 佢咁样赞扬你咧，使你哋生起一种骄傲傲慢心。咁法王话最低限度，你都已经打好咗一个基础，头一个基础咧就系能够坐得正确嘅姿势。佢睇各位坐到都好有正确嘅姿势。
your posture is good. Some of you have been sitting in various directions. The posture has been going in various directions. During the practice, when you are doing the Junedrosum practice, the coming, staying, going practice in Tibetan is Junedrosum. The Junwa is coming, Neba is staying, Drowa is going. So this Junedrosum practice, during this time, your meditation posture should be very straight. If you are doing it as a meditation, sit very straight with the spinal cord behind very straight. Because if your position is straight, then the wisdom thought also comes very straight and the development of the central channel is also improved through this posture.
坐到这个坐禅的姿势是坐到很正确，但是仍然有很多人坐到歪一边歪一边歪来歪去，坐到个不直。是说当我们修这个刚才法王所讲的修这个心的观心的生处自处和去次，这三点的时候，就是修心的三个，这三点就是在西藏文就叫做 从 ne ro sum， 从即系生起 ，ne 即系住 ，ro 即系去，咁即系话生住去三个要点。咁当我哋观呢个心嘅依生住去三个要点嘅。
Yes， your body should be straight， but at the same time， if you make your body very stiff， and if you keep your veins and pulses all pulled and tight, then your meditation will not be able to go on very smoothly. So at the same, when you are sitting up straight, sit in a relaxed position, but make your body straight, so that your body is flexible and not stiff.
So when we are sitting up straight, sit in a relaxed position, but make your body straight, so that your body is flexible and not stiff. 即是要坐到背脊骨也要直，但是如果我们坐的时候很紧张，将肌肉拉到很紧，对于我们观心的三相的时候就观到不是很顺。所以当我们修观心的三，即是生住去三相的时候，修持的时候，我们应该将身体坐到很直。 但是同时呢，要将我们的身体放松自然，所以我们的身呢是很柔软的。So
here, one of the gentlemen right down over there, with glasses. If you're feeling very stiff, it's better to flex and through your features, it is most it will be very beneficial to you if you relax. Don't make your body very stiff. And as the gentleman here is practicing, do not try to sit in the lotus position unless and until you feel comfortable in that. Please sit in the most comfortable position you feel like. It is not that you have to force yourself to sit cross-legged or in the lotus vajra posture. Because if you force your body into any some complicated posture, it is not going to be of benefit, it's going to be of harm to you.
王有注意到，佢話在嗰邊柱頭近住嗰度有一位師兄戴眼鏡嘅咧，係話好對唔住，唔知你名，唔知道點樣稱呼你。佢話佢覺到咧你坐到好硬啊，即係話好緊張冇放鬆。佢話最緊要咧就係我哋坐禪嗰陣時一定要放鬆個身嘅，咁就 要坐得自然，咁另外一位坐喺前面嘅一位師兄咧，咁佢就睇到佢結一個雙盤座，即係一個金剛座。佢話唔需要咁坐，因為當我哋要修觀嗰陣時咧，即係話觀呢個心嘅生住同去嘅三相嗰陣時咧，最好就係我哋將我哋嘅身體坐到最舒服嘅姿勢，越舒服越好。咁但係個身嘅背脊骨咧，仍然係要直。 咁样点解咧？因为如果你夹硬坐一个好似特别一个姿势咧，即系由好似譬如好似坐呢个金刚座咁咧，就对你修观嗰阵时冇咩益处，冇咩帮助噶。
Option practice itself can be divided into six categories. The isolation of body, the isolation of speech, the isolation of mind, the clear light mind practice, the illusion body practice, and the state of unification. The isolation of body, speech, and mind is as in all meditation. The clear light mind practice, the stress that was put into it yesterday during the bardo, at the intermediate state of reality and becoming, if you can practice the clear light mind practice, it is possible to get realization at the state of bardo in this intermediate state of becoming. So today we will deal with how to meditate on the clear light mind practice according to the Dzogchen meditation and what is illusion body.
第三就是修这个光明心的修持，第五就是修这个幻化身的修持，第六是修这个双魂身的修持。昨晚法王为我们解释关于这个中阴的修持，特别是强调这个修这个光明心，因为当我们进入这个 我们死后，我们的意识进入这个法性中阴那个期间呢，如果我们在平日有修持这个光明心呢，在那个时就应用我们平日所修持的光明心，在那个期间呢，来修这个光明心呢，就可以在当时呢，得到正悟的。所以呢，法王就今日特别为我们讲解关于这个修持这个光明心的方法，以及什么是叫做幻化身。
Meditation, the Dzogchen meditation of clear light mind practice, is one of the easiest, shortest, and the most effective method of obtaining realization at the state of
bardo.修这个大圆满中的这个光明心的修持呢，是为最容易、最短促，即系话最迅速以及最有效嘅一种修持嚟噶。
Should you think that you have succeeded? The visualization aspect in this clear light mind practice needs you to visualize an alphabet R in the center of your heart. When this visualization, during the visualization, if you feel the effect of R through heat or through some substantial feeling, then that is the state where you can think that you have gained a considerable amount of experience through this clear light mind practice.
重複，剛才因為我翻譯有多少漏，對不起。他法王說呢，這個大圓滿修這個光明心的修持呢，是為我們在中陰期間最簡單、最容易、最短和最有效的要正悟的方法。 法王话：如果你要知道点样先为之你修这个光明心得到有效果呢，咁就系得到有些少嘅成功呢，就系话当我哋修嘅光明心嘅修持嗰阵时，我哋要观想呢个心中有个阿字嘅。咁如果你观想嗰阵时，你觉到呢个阿字呢，系喺你心中系有带少少嘅热度。 或者係你覺到有多少佢有多少實體性咁樣咧，即係好似實在好似有響度咁樣咧，咁就係代表咧一種象徵咧，代表你已經稍微嘅有少少嘅對呢個修持有少少嘅成功。
The meditation gets obstructed due to the very strong ignorance within ourselves. This ignorance is so powerful that because of this, certain obstructions, chiefly the laziness and the sleepiness that we feel, becomes very strong obstructions of meditation. This clear light mind practice helps in overcoming this obstruction created through ignorance, and also at the same time helps us the helps us and lets us know prehand the various experiences of the bardo. So if we can get realization at the state of bardo, we need not circle within the six realms. That is, then we can divert or pull out our consciousness and keep that consciousness in any pure land that you desire.
當我們修任何一個修持，即是當我們錯禪、錯定的時候，往往由於我們這個無明心的力很強，使到我們有種種的阻隔，尤其是這個懶惰心的阻隔。如果我們能夠修持這個光明心的修持，就能夠幫助我們清除這個由無明心所生起的阻隔。 當我們修心這個光明心的修持修得得力的時候，成功的時候，就可以使我們不會進入這個中陰身，而即是不會進入這個投生中陰的中陰身裡面，而去經歷各種不同的境界的。如果我們不會進入這個投生中有的中陰身裡面，那我們就可以呢 任運的，隨我們中意呢，選擇呢，將我們的心識呢，轉移到去任何一個淨土樹。The
benefits of this Hutsal or the clear light mind practice is that the person who can accomplish this practice can choose the realm he wants to be born in. That means you have the choice of where you want to put your consciousness into. And a person who even does not succeed, even who attempts to practice this, need not be born in the three lower realms. Now during this clear light mind practice, this is performed, the practice is chiefly done before you go to sleep. So when you go to sleep, the time spent, 6 hours or 8 hours or how many other hours you're going to sleep, that is transformed into a kind of meditation. So that when lay people who have a lot of commitments during the daytime cannot find the time to practice, can utilize the time spent in sleep into a meditation. During this clear light mind practice, when you are sleeping, can be done even in a sitting posture, but chiefly done in a lying posture, you have to visualize your body as an hollow object. Meaning that your body is hollow within the inside, does not have any internal organs. Inside your body, you have a lotus bud shaped heart in the center of your heart. In the center here, you have to visualize a heart in the shape of a lotus bud, which is like a lotus bud when you see it early in the morning. That means it's partially open in the top.
有一個選擇，將我哋嘅心識咧移轉去任何一個淨土處，即係你中意去邊一個淨土，你都有呢個自在嘅，有呢個自主。咁以及咧，能夠修得成功咧，呢個修行者咧就唔會墮落呢個三惡道處。咁樣我哋修行呢個光明心嘅時間咧，就係在我哋瞓覺嘅時候。 咁即係話，我哋一日如果瞓8個鐘頭或者係6個鐘頭咧，咁我哋就利用嗰段時間嚟修呢個光明心，即係將我哋嘅睡眠咧轉化為一種修行啦，一種修持。咁樣，所以對嗰啲人有一啲好事務好多嘅人咧，就有好大嘅利益，因為佢哋平時冇時間。 平日事務好多，唔得閒坐禅修行嘅，咁佢就可以利用瞓覺嗰陣時去修啦。咁修光明心嗰陣時，我哋身體嘅姿勢咧就係瞓低瞓字嘅姿勢。 瞓低咗之後咧，我哋要觀賞我哋自己嘅身，我哋個身咧係一個空殼咁樣，入邊空空嘅，係一啲血肉乜都冇，嗰啲五臟六腑乜都冇嘅。咁觀賞咗我哋嘅身係空嘅之外咧，然後在我哋嘅心嗰處咧有一朵蓮花，而我哋要觀賞我哋嘅心咧就係呢朵蓮花啦。呢朵蓮花咧係好似。
The visualization of the heart in the form of a lotus, chiefly if it has four petals. Inside this are a lotus which is red in the outside and internally it is white in color, milky white. Inside this heart, floating, not touching the base, floating a little upward, is the alphabet, Tibetan alphabet, R. This R is white in color, transparently very bright, like the electric bulb that you can see above. The light or the illumination that comes from this alphabet, R, is very strong. As you gain practice, this light coming from the A should increase. Firstly, filling the whole heart. When you gain a considerable amount of experience in this, you can increase the A and the light. The light overflowing the heart and spreading throughout your body. After this, the light again becomes so strong that it comes out through the skin pores, the holes that you've got on the skin, it comes out through that, forcing its way out and illuminates the whole surrounding, the room that you are in. And then as you gain experience, keep on increasing the light, spreading out throughout the surroundings, illuminating the whole area, overflowing from this country to the continent, to the whole world, out of the universe, and spreading to all the six different realms. And when this light spreads, all the bad karmas, unvirtuous actions, the sins, whatever, all the evils get destroyed through the effect of this light. When you gain good practice of this clear light mind, then this R will become, or you will have to increase the size of this R and sometimes decrease the size of this R. When you first begin practicing, the size of the R is as big as the size of a pea, beans or pea seeds, right? Round one. When you are able to practice this further, you can increase the size of the R into a very big size inside a very small lotus. This visualization is very difficult, but the point over here is to train your mind. Sometimes make the lotus as big as a mountain and the R as small as possible. So if you sometimes visualize the sizes of the R as very big or very small, or when you visualize the size of the lotus as very big or small, the concentration that you will be putting in it will be tremendous. And this will help you in controlling your thoughts, in controlling your mind, which in the higher level of meditation can be controlled. And this control gives you control over your consciousness. And then you can divert your consciousness to the realm you desire. The time that we spend from our sleep to the time we wake up can be utilized through this meditation. And when you get the practice, then you will find out that even if you are not fully asleep, even if you are awake, somehow half asleep and half awake, you will not feel tired when you wake up. This practice is considered very good because it enables you to obtain the true body of the five Buddhas.
观想我们的心为一朵莲花的时候，这朵莲花是正华开的，未开晒，好像一个花冧咁。咁佢有四个花瓣，咁呢朵莲花呢， 佢係外咧係紅色，而內向內嗰面咧係奶白色嘅。咁在依朵蓮花嘅中間咧，即係又唔係喺底下，又唔係喺上高，浮喺半入邊中間浮喺樹咧有一個阿字。依個阿字咧係白到好透明嘅。 佢不單止係透明，佢亦好光，會發光嘅。點樣發光呢？即係好似攞而，譬如好似依啲燈泡咁，佢會發出依啲光明嘅。而佢所發嘅。